This video looks at some of the unique aspects of Russia in GMT's pre-war game Gathering Storm. If you've gotten this far in the series without subscribing, it's time to get with the program and click that subscribe button. Russia has always been different from the rest of Europe. In this video, we will look at two aspects of Russia which do not apply to the other four major powers: Russian purges and the Russian cohesion level, and the Russian garrison and its effects. The Russian purge level is important because it determines the Russian cohesion level, and the Russian cohesion level affects play. The Russian purge level is tracked at the bottom of the Russian scenario card. Two counters are provided, one for tens and the other for ones. At the start of the game, the military, party, and no purge cards are in the purge card deck. The Great Purge card is added to the purge card deck when Germany remilitarizes the Rhineland. It is removed from the purge card deck when Russia reaches full cohesion. One purge card is drawn at the start of each turn. A purge card draw is made every turn, regardless of the composition of the purge card deck or whether Russia has reached full cohesion. The effects of the purge card draw are implemented for the turn in which the draw is made. Military and party purges increase the Russian purge level by one. A great purge increases the Russian purge level by three. Even the no purge card draw increases the Russian purge level by one if it eliminates a flag in Russia. When a military purge card is drawn, one active Russian unit is eliminated, becoming a reserve unit. Russia may not use military counters. When a party purge card is drawn, the Russian player has the choice of purging one of the following: research or diplomacy. If Russia purges research, it may not use an activity counter for research, and it does not receive its advanced or intelligence research points. If Russia purges diplomacy, it may not use activity counters for diplomacy. The only exceptions to this are that Russia may place a diplomatic counter in a target containing a Russian spy ring, and may place a diplomatic counter if allowed to do so by a random event. When a Great Purge card is drawn, two active Russian units are eliminated, becoming reserve units. Russia may not use military counters. Russia may not conduct research. Russia may not conduct diplomacy. And Russia may not mobilize. There are a number of Russian national random events that increase the Russian purge level. There is even one general random event that increases the Russian purge level. Russian purge events may be secret negative support events of varying degrees of severity, or conditional support events, which in some circumstances may even be favorable. Russian purge events may purge one or even two active Russian units. The purged Russian units may be undefined, or may be of a specific type. Russian purge events may purge research or diplomacy. If Russia draws a random event that prohibits research or diplomacy in the turn in which it has a party purge, Russia may not conduct either research or diplomacy. If Russia draws a random event that prohibits research or diplomacy in the turn in which it has a great purge, it purges one additional active unit. Russian purge random events therefore always have an effect. The Russian cohesion level depends on the number of Russian purge events. Low cohesion, 0 to 9 purge events. Medium cohesion, 10 to 19 purge events. High cohesion, 20 to 29 purge events. Full cohesion, 30 or more purge events. Russia starts the game at low cohesion. It incurs a minus 1 support penalty. It may only mobilize once every 5 turns, and the anti-Comintern counter is worth 1. When Russia reaches medium cohesion, the minus one support penalty for low cohesion disappears. It may mobilize once every four turns, the anti-common turn counter increases in strength to two, and Russia adds a one counter to its activity counter pool. When Russia reaches high cohesion, its support level goes up by one. It may mobilize once every three turns. The anti-common turn counter increases in strength to three, and Russia adds a two counter to its activity counter pool. When Russia reaches full cohesion, its support level goes up by an additional one. It may mobilize every second turn. Russia adds a three counter to its activity counter pool. The Great Purge card is removed from the Purge card deck, and Purge events give Russia research points. Russia draws additional random events. Russia may place diplomatic counters in more countries, and flags in Russia are no longer allowed, and existing flags are eliminated at the rate of one each turn. The Russian garrison is tracked on the Russian scenario card. At the start of the game, counters are placed as indicated. There are no Japanese flag counters, because those are always negative Russian garrison modifiers. The positive modifiers that improve Russia's garrison situation are one for each active armor, infantry, and air unit. Research results, as set out in the video on research results. Russian flags in minor countries, one modifier if Russia has one or two flags in a minor country, two modifiers if Russia has a trade pact in a minor country. One modifier for each level of allied advantage in the armor, infantry, or air balance of power. The naval balance of power and the battleship race don't affect the Russian garrison. These positive modifiers are compared to the following negative modifiers. The Japanese forces in Manchuria, which consist of two armor, three infantry, and three air units. The eight Japanese modifiers never change. One modifier for each level of Axis advantage in the armor, infantry, or air balance of power. Again, the naval balance of power and the battleship race don't count. The European Aggression Index, one for each positive European Aggression Index level. A zero or negative European Aggression Index has no effect. Axis or Allied flags in minor countries bordering Russia. For Poland, one modifier if the Axis or Allies have one or two flags in Poland, two modifiers if the Axis or Allies have a trade pact with Poland, one modifier for each Axis or Allied trade pact in Finland, Romania, or Turkey, and one modifier for a six-step occupation policies research result, two additional modifiers for a 12-step result. Here is an example of the Russian garrison from the last turn of a recent game, which was winter 1938. The positive and negative modifiers are paired off to determine the net Russian garrison surplus or deficit. The Axis had a net advantage of plus 4 in the non-naval balance of power. This was countered by 4 active Russian units. The Axis had flags in Finland, Romania, and Turkey, and the European Aggression Index was plus 3. These 6 modifiers were countered by Russian research results. With all the negative modifiers countered, Russia had a surplus of 2 from an armor result and an active air unit. This gave Russia plus 1 support. The Russian garrison is checked at the following times. During the income phase, after purge effects and random events are implemented. At the end of the economic phase, after research and construction, when the Nazi-Soviet pact is negotiated, and when Russia tries to declare war. The Russian garrison level has 2 effects. The main effect is that the Russian support level may be increased or decreased by the Russian garrison level. This affects Russian income, whether Russia is compelled to build a unit, and the pact and Russian declaration of war calculations. However, regardless of the Russian support level, Russia must have a garrison surplus to use military counters for diplomacy in bordering countries. The Russian player can't do anything about the Russian purges and random events, other than react to them. But Russia does have some control over its garrison, And managing this and the Russian support level is one of the most important aspects of playing Russia well in Gathering Storm. In most Gathering Storm games, Britain, France, and Russia are played by the same person, and the Russian spending, research, and diplomatic decisions can be almost an afterthought. They shouldn't be. The fact that Russia's options are sometimes limited can mean that choosing wisely can be even more crucial than for the other major powers.
Outside the barracks, by the corner light, I'll always stand and wait for you at night. We will create a world for two. I'll wait for you the whole night through. For you, Lily